An official Microsoft support agent ran an exploit on my PC. How did that happen? Well, we need to backtrack a little. In 2020, I built a PC and bought a Windows 10 license from the Microsoft Store. The license was bound to my account, as was my PC. Now, when Microsoft announced that support for Windows 10 would end in October 2025, I tried to upgrade to Windows 11, but alas, my computer did not have a TPM, and so I could not do a direct upgrade. Oh well, I thought, it's been about 5 years now, I should probably just build another PC. And I did. A beast of one, I might add. So when it came to doing the upgrade to Windows 11, I did a bit of research and I found that you could actually switch a license from one PC to another, assuming you were doing an upgrade like I was. This should have been quite a simple activation. Apparently, you could go to the activation screen, say that you changed your hardware, and then just select the old PC with the old license and switch it over. When I tried to do this, however, Microsoft said I didn't have any PCs on my account, despite the fact if I logged into my Microsoft account online and clicked devices, both were there. So I contacted support using the Get Help option on the activation page and requested a callback. This was the beginning of the saga. Approximately half an hour later, I got the callback from Microsoft support and I talked with a person who went through all the steps that I had already tried. Because, you know, of course that would happen. They then decided that they couldn't help me, and so they put me on hold for 30 minutes while they were transferring me to somebody who could help. Now, at this point, I should note that they did say they were transferring me, but they also said they were going to tell the person exactly what my issue was. So you can imagine my surprise when half an hour later, somebody picks up and asks what my problem is. "Didn't the last person tell you?" I ask. "No, this wasn't a transfer, it's a new call." Well, it wasn't. I don't know how Microsoft's support system works, but hey, I was just glad to be off hold. So I explain the problem to this new person, they try a few more things and cannot help me, so they transfer me again. And approximately 20 minutes later, I talked to a new person who had no idea what my problem was. They were even more unhelpful, to be honest. They spoke with me for 5 minutes, vaguely mentioned that perhaps we had to reinstall Windows 10, which I'd never installed on this PC before, to do the upgrade, and then literally just put me on hold without telling me anything. I hung up. At this point, I'd been on the phone for about an hour and a half, obviously mostly on hold, so I was doing other stuff, but it was just frustrating. So I used the Get Help menu again and requested another callback. This one took about 4 hours, maybe five, in order to receive the callback, and the person I spoke to initially was actually really helpful. She gave me a request ID that I could use to trace the problem through the system in case she had to transfer me. However, she couldn't help either, and she did indeed say that she needed to transfer my call to somebody else. Again, she said she was going to tell the person she was transferring me to everything that was going on, but 25 minutes later, I had another person who had no idea who I was or what the problems were. However, I did give them my request ID, and so they did have some information from that, thankfully. Notably that this was a Windows activation issue. They ummed and ahed and suggested, okay, well, let me take remote control of your computer using the quick assist function built into Windows. Fine, that's okay. I have nothing on this computer anyway, no work, anything like that. It's a fresh install. So they do that and they start trying to reinstall Windows 11 by downloading the ISO, opening it up, running the setup script. This takes about 20 minutes, at which point Windows 11 needs to reboot, which it does, and then we reconnect and let the agent take over my machine again. He goes to try and activate Windows, and the same thing happens because Of course it did. I installed Windows 11 fine the first time. So this is where the story gets a little weird. I've been tweeting this the entire time, by the way, ever since the first call. Because, you know, I was frustrated that it was taking so long, and I'd been moved around the system without the next person being told who I was, what my problem was. It's frustrating, so I was venting on Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it now. A few people had suggested using a site called massgrave.dev, which contains Microsoft Activation Scripts, or MAS, M-A-S. These are completely unofficial and technically illegal scripts that would activate Windows without requiring a license. That's why they're illegal, right? They're technically exploits. The dev team have written articles about the exploits they use to bypass the Windows activation. So yeah, these are malicious, although arguably they could be good, I guess. It depends on your worldview. However, they are malicious exploits. They're basically allowing anyone to activate Windows without purchasing a license, which is technically a bypass. So I didn't really want to do that. I'd already bought a Windows 10 license 5 years ago for $200. I could transfer it for free according to everything online that I'd read. I didn't really want to go an exploit route. That just felt kind of shady. I'm trying to be an honest guy. But hey, the option was there. Lots of people were suggesting it. Anyway, back to the story. The guy who's just installed Windows 11, he's back remoted onto my PC. He tried to activate Windows again and failed. And so what does he do? But he opens up PowerShell. And he types in the exploit code that he needs to fetch the exploit script and run it. And then he runs it in front of me, obviously assuming I don't know what he's doing. But it's the legitimate exploit script. It's from the third-party domain. And yeah, he activates Windows that way. And then goes to the activation screen, points out that it's activated, and is basically like, well, I managed to activate it. Okay. So, I'm in two minds. Obviously, it's good that I have an activated Windows 11 product. I don't really like the way he did it, because here's the thing. It's an exploit. It's a third-party exploit. It's not sanctioned by Microsoft. It's technically hosted on Microsoft servers because it's on GitHub, but, you know, it's not a good thing. Like, the real thing that I sort of crossed my mind was that it's a third-party domain, and there's the risk there that if somebody compromises that domain, they can just replace the script with whatever they want, right? They could inject some code. So it still activates Windows, but it also installs a backdoor. Like, there's no way of knowing unless you actually review the code that it's downloading. And the script authors have said that, you know, it uses a hash to do integrity checks. But here's the thing. The initial loader, the initial script that loads, if you have control over that domain, you could just replace the hash with a valid hash. Hashing checks integrity of the file. It doesn't check who wrote the file. It's not a signature, right? And there's no way of doing signature checking on this because it is just a script, right? It's not being signed by Microsoft. So yeah, it's just odd. I'm sure that it's not malicious because, like they've said, it's been reviewed by a lot of people. They aren't aware of any compromises. They claim that they, you know, review it very, very regularly, and they would know if it's been replaced. I kind of trust them on that. They seem like pretty decent people. But still, it doesn't really sit well with me. And especially the fact that Microsoft support did it. And this kind of opens up just another angle, which is, why would they do it? Is the Windows activation functionality so broken that support agents of having to use a third-party exploit just to solve customer issues? And why do they need to do that? Do they do it because they need to close these cases? Is that the reason? I imagine so. I know that some call centers, especially tech support, if you don't close enough cases, you may get penalized, right? Your job might be at risk. So this guy had been on the phone with me for 25 minutes, right? It took 20 minutes just to install Windows 11. Maybe after half an hour, it counts against him. And so he felt like he was compelled to at least figure out the issue. Remember, this was the fifth person I talked to that day. So maybe it was going against a lot of people. I don't know. Either way, I thought it would be funny just to share this weird story about how Microsoft technically ran an exploit on my PC to activate Windows 11. And yeah, I'd love to know your thoughts, so please leave them in the comments, give this video a like, and yeah, subscribe to my channel. Maybe we'll have some more stories about this someday.